Dear students, welcome to the science class. So in the last class, we completed the topic named as acid, bases and salts. So today we are going to discuss about the exercise questions which are going to come in this topic. So let us consider the first question here. State the difference between the acids and bases. State the difference between the acids and bases. So let us take acid. In this column we are going to take the base. So you already know that acids are nothing but acids are the sovereign test. So the substance which are sovereign test are nothing but acids. In the same manner, base is nothing but what? Which contains bitter test. So the first difference will be what? It will be the sovereign test. It is sovereign test, whereas base is bitter in test. It is bitter in taste, right? So another thing, it is the first difference. Another thing, how we are going to identify the acid as well as base? First, by the testing it, it is not possible to test every substance. So that we are going to use the indicators. So we have three natural indicators. We have four natural indicators. We are using only three natural indicators in this topic. So the first natural indicator is nothing but it is the litmus paper, and acid when react with the blue litmus paper, it turns the color of the blue litmus to the red, whereas bases are going to change the color of the red litmus to the blue color. So it will be the second difference. Here the acids are changing the color of blue litmus to the red. Change of blue litmus to the red color. Blue litmus to the red color. In the same manner, if you take the base here, base is going to change the color of the red litmus to the blue color. So, change of red litmus to the blue color. Red litmus to the blue color. So if you check the litmus paper, if the litmus paper is red colored, then bases are going to change the red color to the blue color. If it is acid, then acid is going to change the blue colored litmus paper to the red color. So this is the second difference. I want to take the third difference. We have another indicator that is nothing but turmeric as well as we have the China rose. So in the turmeric is again converted into the yellow colored sheets of the paper. So when you dip the yellow colored sheets of the paper of the turmeric in an acid, it is not going to change the color of that solution, right? But when you dip the, or if you add the turmeric solution in base, that turmeric solution is going to change its color. It is going to change its color to the pink color, right? So then pink or red color, so that we can identify that it is going to change the color into the red, so that we can identify the base as well as acid by the what? By the turmeric indicator. In the same manner, if you take the China rose also, in the China rose petal solution, if you add acidic solution, in an acidic solution, if you add China rose petal solution as the indicator, the color of that thing is going to change into the magenta color. So we already know that pinkish color of the China rose is there in that solution. If you add that thing, the color of the acid solution is going to change into the magenta color. That is nothing but darkish pink color. Right? In the same manner, if you add the China rose solution into the base solution, what will happen? The base solution is going to change the color of that pink to a green color. So that by that thing we can identify the base as well as we can identify the acidic solution. Right, by those indicators are going to show us the acidic as well as basic solution. So these are some differences of the acidic solution as well as basic solution. Now next thing, the second question. So what is the second question here? Ammonia is found in the many household products such as window cleaner. it turns red litmus to the blue. What is the nature? What is the nature? So if you see here, ammonia is found in many household products such as window cleaners. It turns red litmus to the blue color. It is turning the red litmus to the blue color. So what is the nature? What is the nature of the ammonia? So already we discussed about the red litmus paper and blue litmus paper while discussing about the difference between the acids as well as base. Right, you see here the ammonia changing the color of the red litmus to the blue color. That means it is a basic nature. It is basic in nature. Why? Bases are only those things which are going to change the color of the red litmus to the blue, whereas acids are going to change the color of the blue litmus to the red color. So if the color change of red litmus to the blue color, then we can say that ammonia is basic in nature. We can say that ammonia is basic in nature. Right? If the blue litmus is turning the its color to the red, then it can be acid. But here the red litmus is changing its color to the blue. For that reason, it is a basic solution. So next question number 3 here. Let us consider the question number 3. Name the source from which litmus solution A is obtained, and what is the use of this solution? What is the use of this solution? So name the source from which litmus solution is obtained. So from where we are going to extract the litmus solution? We are extracting the litmus solution from the leachates. So litmus solution is extracted from where? It is extracted from the leachates. So here's the source of the litmus is what? It is nothing but it is the leachates only. Right? Then what is the use of the litmus solution? Litmus solution can be used for the identification of the acidic as well as basic nature of substances. So for the identification of acids and bases, we are going to use the litmus solution. So this is the one of the main important use of the litmus solution. That is nothing but identification of acidic as well as basic solution by adding of the litmus solution in a solution of acidic or basic nature substances. Right. Now next, take the fourth question. Is the distilled water is acidic, basic or neutral? How do you verify it? Is the distilled water is acidic, basic or neutral? Right. So how you are going to verify it? So we already know that distilled water is a neutral solution. Distilled water is a neutral solution. So therefore, distilled water is a neutral solution. Distilled water is a neutral solution. So how we are going to verify it? We are going to take 3 containers. In those 3 containers, we are going to add the distilled water. In those 3 containers, what we are going to do? We are going to add the distilled water like this. So let us this fourth question, and this is the first test tube, second test tube, and third test tube. So in the first test tube, we are going to add the distilled water. In the second test tube, also we are going to add the distilled water. In the third test tube, also we are going to add the distilled water. So we already know that for the verification of the acidic and basic solution, what we are going to use? We are going to use the litmus solution. So we are going to add few drops of the litmus solution in the this test tube 1, few drops in the test tube 2, and few drops in the test tube 3. Right now we can take only one test tube also. Not 3 test tubes, we are going to take only one test tube. In that test tube, we are going to add the distilled water. In that distilled water, we are going to add few drops of the litmus solution. When we add a few drops of the litmus solution, if the color of the distilled water changes to the red color, then we can say it has an acidic solution. If the color changes to the blue color, then we can say it has a basic solution. If there is no color change occurred, then we can say it has a neutral solution. So see here, if I add a few drops of the litmus solution into this container, then that container is not going to change its color. If it is not changing its color, then we can say it has the solution which is there in the test tube. It is a neutral solution. It is a neutral solution. So we are identifying, we are verifying the distilled water as a neutral solution by adding the few drops of the litmus solution. After adding of the few drops of the litmus solution, there is no color changes occurred in that litmus solution. For that reason, we can say that distilled water is a neutral solution. Right. I hope this is clear. So next page on the fifth question here. Describe the process of neutralization with the help of an example. Describe the process of neutralization with the help of an example. So we already know that neutralization reaction is nothing but when acid and base react together, they are going to give a neutral solution. That neutral solution has the neither has the acidic nature or nor basic nature, so that the solution is known as neutral. So this reaction is known as what? This reaction is known as neutralization reaction. So they told you to describe the process of the neutralization with the help of the example. Right. So while taking an example, we should take an acidic solution and another as the basic solution. When we mix acidic and basic solution, they are going to neutralize both the things, or they are going to nullify the effect of the both the things. Like acids try to nullify the effect of the base, whereas base try to nullify the effect of the acid. So there will be no extra effect will be remains. So those effects will be what? Those effects will be neutral in nature. So let us take an example here. I am going to take an example of the hydrochloric acid. Which is going to react with the sodium hydroxide. Which is going to react with what? Sodium hydroxide. So when this acid, that nothing but hydrochloric acid, reacts with the base, that nothing but sodium hydroxide, they are going to give a neutral solution, that nothing but salt and water. So when hydrochloric acid reacts with the sodium hydroxide, it is going to give the sodium chloride. It is going to give sodium chloride along with that water. Whereas sodium chloride is nothing but what? It is a salt solution. Right? Which is neutral in nature. So when acid reacts with the base, they are going to produce salt and water. So this reaction is known as neutralization reaction. Why it is neutralization reaction? This acid tries to nullify the effect of the base, whereas this base tries to nullify the effect of the acid. Because of that, whatever the compound, whatever the product which is going to come, it is neither showing the acidic nature nor basic nature, so then it is becoming a neutral. Where neutral solution forms, that reaction is known as neutralization reaction. So this is the example for the neutralization reaction. Now let us take the question number 6 here. Mark B, if the statement is true, and F, if it is false. So here they are given some statements. We have to tell that the statement is true or false. So let us consider the first statement here. Nitric acid turns red litmus to the blue color. Is it possible? See here. Here they are given the nitric acid. So nitric acid is nothing but it is an acid. It is turning the red litmus to the blue color. Is it possible? We already know that litmus paper, that is nothing but acids are going to turn the blue litmus to the red color, whereas bases are going to turn the red color to the blue color. See here, if nitric acid is an acid, it is turning the red litmus to the blue color. Is it possible? So it is not possible. Because of that, the first statement is completely false. So the first statement is false statement. Next, consider the second statement here. Sodium hydroxide turns blue litmus red. So see here the example only, we have given the sodium hydroxide as base. So sodium hydroxide has the basic in nature. So we already know that for identification of the basic nature, we are going to use the red litmus. So that red litmus is going to change its color to the blue color. But in the statement that is given, sodium hydroxide turns blue color to the red. Is it possible? No, it is not possible. So this statement is also false. The second statement is also false. Why it is false? Here this should be sodium hydroxide terms and it must be blue. It is the correct statement. Right. So for that reason, second statement is also wrong. Now let us consider the third statement here. Sodium hydroxide and hydrochloric acid neutralize each other and form salt and water. Here in the third statement they are given, sodium hydroxide and hydrochloric acid neutralize each other and form salt and water. So we take here in this example, that is nothing but hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide neutralizing each other and then forming the sodium chloride and water. So this example is given as the statement here. So this statement is right or wrong? It will be completely right. So this is a true statement. The statement is true. Next, consider the fourth statement here. Indicator is a substance which shows different color in acidic and basic solution. Indicator is a substance which shows different color in acidic and basic solution. So is it right statement? Why we are using the indicator? We are using the indicator of identification of the acidic as well as basic solution. So how we are going to identify the acidic and basic solutions? By using the indicators. How the indicators are going to give the observations here? They are going to give the observation by the change in the color. If you check the litmus paper also, litmus paper is an indicator which turns blue to the red when it is added into the acidic solution, and when it is added into the basic solution, it is going to change its color from red to the blue. Right. In the same way, if you take all the indicators, they are going to show the acidic and basic nature by the change in the color of the litmus paper. So this statement is also correct. So this statement is also that is nothing but indicator is a substance which shows different color in acidic as well as basic solutions. Right. Now let us consider the last statement, that is nothing but fifth statement. Tooth decay is caused by the presence of the base. Tooth decay is caused by the presence of the base. If you remember the last class, in that last class we were discussing about the neutralization reaction in daily life. So in that daily life we discussed about the tooth decay. So how does the tooth decay is going to happen? If the leftover food is present in between gums of the teeth, so those food particles are nothing but maybe carbonate particles or maybe sugar particles. Those food particles are going to be utilized by the bacteria which are present inside our mouth. So while utilizing those leftover food particles by the bacteria, those bacteria are going to release some amount of acid. Because of those acids, our tooth starts to decay. So then it is because of the acid, tooths are decaying, not because of the base. So we can say that this statement is also completely false. So tooth decay is caused by the presence of the acid, not by the base. So for the nullifying, for the preventing the tooth decay, we are brushing our teeth 2 times a day. By using the toothpaste. So where we are using the toothpaste, that toothpaste having a basic in nature. That has the basic in nature. So this statement is completely wrong. It is also false. So this is the answer for the question number 6. So we are going to discuss the remaining questions in the next class. So it is not possible to cover all those questions. So I am going to make another class in the next class. We are going to discuss the remaining questions. Up to that point, thank you. Take care. Stay well. Stay home.